I know what I'm about to say now is controversial, but I have to say it. This nation cannot continue turning a blind eye and a deaf ear to the taking of some 4,000 unborn children's lives every day, one every 21 seconds. We cannot pretend the belief that each life is sacred when we've permitted the deaths of 15 million helpless innocents since the Roe versus Wade decision. 15 million children who will never laugh, never sing, never know the joy of human love, will never strive to heal the sick, feed the poor, or make peace among nations. Abortion has denied them the first and most basic of human rights. We are all infinitely poorer for their loss.
I think abortion is a moral issue and an ethical issue. I think that those who are pro-choice make a mistake.
Yes, was it tarde kabisa, mambo ya abortion.
What you need to do is take one tablet a day and you're gonna be fine. You're gonna be fine. Don't worry. Don't worry. You're gonna be fine. Everything is okay. Everything is okay.
It was deadly, I tell you. And that made me realize that the life we hold within can only be crushed or protected by the fingertips of our hands. I made a choice, a foolish one, as bitter as those herbs, my little friend.
But ma'am, why do you always cover your face with a gray scarf?
Well, I have no choice. My life in solitude and shame has cultured me to hide. Even if it means burying my head in the sand.
But you say we should always be happy.
It's true, Winnie. And that's why she gave birth to you. Many mothers across the world are proud of little angels like you all. Your mother, she is too. She's strong, you know. I used to sit on the front step of my home, breathing in the fragrance of the autumn leaves, admiring the perfect blue sky. That was my only hope out of life's pain and misery. It was hell on earth when my husband came home drunk. I hated it.
Wa mama musilale. Lale, lale, wa mama musilale. Ratuma pambano. Wewe, hauna hata haibu. What is it? What are you looking at? Stop looking at me. I'm not those bloody fruits you sell at wherever. Wa mama musilale. Lale, lale. Wa mama musilale.
Heart-piercing words were always accompanied by a nauseating stench of alcohol from Eddie's mouth. Oh, the memory. That man was like a chameleon. He changed his colors frequently, but I knew his true colors, though. I loved it when he made jokes and we suddenly burst into laughter. I love how
we hold our hands, how we share the little that we have, and I promise to be your friend, both in deed and in need.
My love, you don't need to promise. I've seen the light through you, and you brighten my days as well.
Come on, love. But are you going out to the social hall tonight? There's a dance and I want us to get boogie, honey.
Someone just asked me out. But hey, what the hell? Why not? Let's vunja mifupas kama bado ziko. But hey, be warned, I dance better than you, you know?
I can almost taste the victory. We'll see about that, huh? I'm scared.
The cheer and glory that reigned through that night still lingers around my memory because music was life in the 80s. Eddie was popular, well-talented, and you know what? Every time he danced and kissed me on my forehead, he made life out of leaves as he took care of me like a princess.
But he looks sad. Will you always grow like that?
You see, God has blessed us differently, and we do pay for our mistakes. Let me tell you something. What was once hidden was yet to come to light. I will make it brief for you, angel, before it's too dark for you to go home. I was just a little girl with more than life expectations. I was a dreamer. I wanted to be free. I thought babies were a burden, but it's too late for me to treasure one. Look at me, Grace. I speak to you as a true victim of child termination. I disappointed our forefathers. Oh yes, I did, my dear friend.
How's my baby growing? I may be a drunky, but today I have to see that twinky little portrait of mine, eh? I have to see it grow.
Yes, I'm feeling a bit off the record. Maybe a little bit sick, but all is well.
Oh yes, it is. Mke wangu, unaugua wapi lakini? Neza kupeleka hata Jamaica ukapate matibabu hivi sasa. Kumbuka tunamchunga nani? Tunamchunga mtoto wetu mpenzi, jamani.
Tuache hapo mpenzi. Wanawake wana nguvu, usisahau. I'm just fine. I want to talk, honey.
Don't mention it today. I will talk on your behalf. Don't tire your lips, baby. Eh? You can preserve them for me, you know. You know?
It is quite serious. I want to say something. I just have to.
I know you love me very much, and I'm sure you want to tell me the joy is spreading a bit too much on us, eh? Mwanambere muyaye, mwanambere muyaye. I love that song, eh? Je mwanangu, amka tushiriki dance jamani.
Nimesema niwachwe, usiniguze. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say that.
It's okay, eh? I know the baby needs peace, it's okay, don't cry. It's all good, jamani, it's all good.
I may not be perfect, I have to say this. I'm not.
I know you're not feeling good, and I promise to take good care of you and Junior.
I said I'm not.
Ala? Vipi wewe? Enough of this woman. Ah.
Just look at me, and look at me keenly. What is the difference between my tummy and my makapi's tummy? Nothing, I guess. We are all full as we take more than enough potatoes each and every second we sit by the marketplace. My love, I may be your wife, but I have to confess. And before I say this, I know I may sound like a demon or rather a witch.
You know, the last time I heard of such a speech, it was the first time I knew my late Uncle Rex had passed on. And now you have a second one. Talk, woman!
I'm not!
Ha! I knew it. Women. Now she won't talk. I think today I have soothed you enough. I can now redeem my bonga points. Talk, woman!
You know what? Worry no more. Why are you that rude to me? Is that how tradition has taught you to treat your woman?
Cut the crap and talk, woman! Chop chop!
I just want us to get a second child.
First, deliver Junior, then think about being a mother, not a talented conceiver.
I can't deliver.
Okay. Then store it safely and keep it for a few more years. You're funny, you know. How funny my junior will be, yeah?
I'm not pregnant.
Enough of the dry jokes and...
What dry jokes? I am not and have never been. I wanted to talk to you, but you never gave me a chance.
Yeah? What are you talking about?
I once had the chance, but I whisked it away. I care about you and I couldn't tell you just abruptly. I may be a witch, a demon, or any grotesque figure you have ever seen. But my husband, I today come clean and confess to you. I am an abortion victim.
When we make wrong decisions, we at times think the repercussions are immediate, forgetting the end of the tunnel. The last time I saw Eddie, a loud bang of the front door followed and he went off just like the wind. I may have lived a couple of years in solitude, but till the day I see the face of my creator, I'm sure to pay the price of an abortion, and truth be told, life has to move on. So now, little girls and sweet boys, please run along to your homes, because tomorrow is indeed another day.